ratings programs. In this video we're going to be having a look at another region device. You've probably seen the previous one that I did for the SNES Universal Adapter. You probably saw the Yozo 2-in-1 signal converter for NTSC and PAL PlayStations to be connected to a PAL TV. You've probably seen the DVD region converter for PlayStation 2 that allows you to play import DVD movies on this one model of PlayStation 2. Now we're going to be looking at the megakey 3. This device is for Sega Mega Drive. It allows you to play any game on any Mega Drive. Of course, we also have something that's a little bit more interesting as well. We've got these dip switches on the back. There's something quite interesting about this, which is not documented online. It might be of useful knowledge for some, that it might actually allow you to combine different regions of Mega Drive and Mega CD add-ons. So let's take a look at this. What we have here, we have a PAL Sega Mega Drive 2, we also have a PAL Mega CD 2, so you can see that's my Sega Mega CD setup. I'm just going to look at the dip switches, the Mega Key, 1, 2, 3, 4, chart says, right, what we're going to do, we're going to trick our PAL Mega CD into thinking that it has been connected to a Japanese Mega Drive 2. So we're going to pretend that the Mega Drive is Japanese and we're going to set it to the Japanese region code. Everything is set to off. Okay, I don't believe that actually works. Okay, we're going to trick it into thinking that the Mega Drive is for the American market. So I'm going to switch dip switch to on. Right, so switch 2 is on. And we'll put switch 4 on as well, which should make it run at NTSC speed, I suspect. Please press reset button again. Ah, there we go. Oh well, this is a PAL CCAM compatible Mega CD and will not operate in NTSC regions. Is that for cool then? Now, unfortunately, I can't say for sure as to whether I'd actually be able to get an actual Japanese Mega Drive, a real Japanese Mega Drive, to work with a PAL Mega CD by setting the cartridge this way, because I don't actually have any NTSC Mega Drives. But there you go, a Mega Key will actually allow you to change the region of your Mega Drive and get it to actually work possibly with a different region of Mega CD. Pretty cool. Another cartridge I found that can do this also is the Code Buster. Codebuster. It's like a mega key, but it's not quite as good. It will allow you to play American coded Mega Drive games on a PAL system, but not vice versa. And it won't let you play Brazilian or Japanese coded games because there's no diff switches. It's just been hard coded. I bought this for a while because I struggled in attaining a mega key. That's the code buster. Basically a poor man's mega key, more or less. As you see, it's quite different. However, if you like the idea of getting an American Mega CD to work with a PAL Mega Drive, this might be useful to you. Okay. I just need to get this to actually go in right. The slot where it's kind of cursed on this. There we go. It's a bit tight, but then. Yes, again, it works. This is a PAL Seacom compatible Mega CD and will not for NTC regions. So yeah, a code buster will allow you possibly to use an American Mega CD with a PAL Mega Drive. In the same way as it will allow you to use an American games cartridge with a PAL Mega Drive. That's not really the funny thing, because essentially that means that the Mega CD boots like a game cartridge, as it has its own boot ROM. So I'm having to keep the volume low because everybody are like in bed at the moment. Hey, that's life. Live and let live. Rock on. Welcome, fellow souls. So yeah, that's a hard-coded American game cartridge. Game pack is not designed for your Genesis. Namco Limited. So yeah, that's the wonder of a code buster. And finally, we have the easiest and the cheapest of the Mega Drive adapters. The so-called Honeybee adapter. So-called because the Honeybee made ones were the most common. This is basically a pass-through adapter, and it does bypass the shape of Japanese cartridges, but it will not allow you to play coded games like the Code Buster or the Mega Key. It is just a simple slot-through adapter. If you open these cartridges up, you'll find there is no actual circuit, logic or anything inside. As you can see here. Rather, it's designed for the Japanese carts, which you can see have a very different shape from the US ones. They don't slot in the PAL units. must know that some of these game cartridges haven't been used for a number of years. Let's just say that. So I wouldn't expect them to like run so immediately. There we go. Veritex, which is a non-coded Japanese game. Last and not least, we have PAL coded games. Those happen to be optimised. Just wait this minute. So, of course, we would consider that the Codemaster would allow you to play American coded games on the European console. But I can tell you for sure that it will not allow you to play European coded games on the American console. But let's give it a try anyway. Right, we're going to be really weird and put PAL game, or PAL Codebuster. I'm going to put it into a North American Sega Genesis Nomad console. And switch it on. Around a bit. The nature of these things. The message, would it? It's probably confused. Okay, let's just get a PAL coded game running in this US machine. Yep, we can be certain it's the game cartridge. Sony PAL French C can megadrive systems. I feel like single-handedly saving the universe. Yeah, there we go. Still comes up with it. As it still thinks it's a PAL game, so we know that while it gets American games running on the European machine, the reverse is not true. Now, of we attach it to the mega key for friendship pal CCAN games. We'll want switches 1 and 2 on, switches 3 and 4 off. You can see here. There's autofocus on this thing is nuts. Oh, that really matters. Right. In we go. Got switches 1, 2 and 4 on. Leaving 4 off doesn't seem to work for Shinobi. I forgot about what the iPad actually does. So cool. One last thing. Just a little bit of Pac-Man 2 running in its native hardware. It's the speed difference compared to when we played in the Pound Mega CD. There you have it. Thank you very much for watching. Hello. helps you a bit when you go shopping for fridge adapters. So now you need a three major types of fridge adapter that are available today. Make CD owners. And of course, apart from the Brazilian cartridges, I can't really wrap around that since I don't have any Brazilian games. But I don't really think there was ever really a specific type of adapter for those other than the rather universal megakey. So, yeah. Alright, take care of all your programs. Enjoy your ride. If you can.